Hello viewers, my name is Dr. Moniyi Adeoye. You are welcome again to Medical Tips on Ogongo TV. Today, I want to talk to you on how to boost your immune system. Before I proceed, I'd like you to subscribe to my channel and also click on the notification bell so that you can get notified when we drop new content. Thank you so much for doing that. How to boost your immune system. I want to talk about this because of the presence of COVID-19. Because our immune system plays a key role as to whether one will fall sick or not. As a matter of fact, working in the background of our body system is the immune system, which performs the function of protecting our body against microorganisms like fungi, viruses, bacteria, parasites, in order to protect our body against diseases. It is a complex network of organs, cells, and some proteins that act in a coordinated manner to protect our body against pathogens. Some people get sick more often, while some people get sick less often. This is because of the immune system. Our immune system is the first line of defense against microbes entering our body. When your immune system is strong, you will rarely get sick. Or when you fall sick, it will not overwhelm your system. When your immune system is strong, you are likely to fall sick less often. Or when you fall sick, there is every tendency that it will not overwhelm your system. But if your immune system is weak, you are likely to fall sick more often. And when you fall sick, there is tendency that it will overwhelm you. It's important that we work on our immune system. It is possible for us to improve our immune system. Do you know that in your mouth there are a lot of microorganisms? In your nose, they are there. In your intestines, there are a lot of microorganisms that performs the function of defense against foreign microorganisms. They fight against them. They don't allow them. They don't want them to come and dominate. Those ones that are in your body system are the normal flora. For you to improve your immune system, you will do the following things. Number one, avoid taking heavily processed food. You see, heavily processed meals have been linked to increased inflammation, reduction in control over infection, increase in the rate of developing cancers, and increase in the rate of developing allergies and autoimmune diseases. So if you want your immune system to be strong, there's a need for you to reduce heavily processed meal. Number two, increase the intake of your vitamins and minerals. Vitamins are essential to life. They are organic compounds that are required in balanced diet. You see, we have different types of vitamins and minerals. They are micronutrients that you find in fruits and vegetables. Vitamins and minerals are important in the proper functions of our immune system. The immune cells need a lot of vitamins to reproduce. All these vitamins and minerals are found naturally in vegetables and fruits, although there are some other drugs that combines vitamins and minerals together, multivitamins. You know them. I know you know them. But the important thing I'm telling you now is that if you want your immune system to be strong, you need adequate vitamins and minerals. Number three, exercise. You see, when you exercise frequently and moderately, it helps to stimulate your immune system and strengthens infection defense. Doing exercise frequently is associated with the reduction of protein levels, and this consequently reduces the rate of inflammation and stress in the body. Apart from reducing protein level, frequent exercise can reduce your body fat. And you know, this excess in body fat is associated with increase in blood pressure, obesity, and cardiovascular diseases. Frequent exercise will regulate your body flow and lymphatic flow, and this can actually help in removing infections from the body and even cancer cells. I recommend that you do moderate exercise at least 3 times every week for 30 to 50 minutes. It is good for your body system. Number 4, reduce your stress. It is understandable that for now, everybody is passing through a lot of stress. But it is also important that we know how to reduce this stress. I recommend that for you to reduce your stress on a daily basis, you should meditate in the morning. Before you go out, before you face the challenges of the day, learn to meditate every morning between 20 minutes to 30 minutes so that you will plan your day. You would have planned how you will face those challenges, and then you determine how you run your day from beginning to the end. By doing this, the amount of stress that you will encounter, if you did not do that, will be reduced. I want you to do this. I want you to reduce your stress for also this important reason: to reduce your aging process. When you reduce your stress, you are reducing the rate at which you age. If stress is too much, you are likely to age faster. Number 5, adequate sleep. Get adequate sleep. We are talking about how to boost your immune system. When you sleep very well, I mean, sleeping very well for an adult is between 6 to 8 hours every day. When you have this kind of sleep, your body system will relax. Your immune system will be excited. Your body will release certain chemicals called cytokines, which also play important roles in fighting infection. A teenager, between 9 to 10 hours in a day, there is a particular period of time in the middle of the night that you need to sleep very well. I tell you, between 12:30 a.m. and 2:30 a.m., you need a sound sleep. We should not cultivate the habit of being awake during those period of time frequently, because that time you need your body to rest, and at that time your body is likely to release cytokines that will be adequate enough for your body to function maximally against infection. Apart from those that I have said, I like you to stop smoking, because smoking can reduce your immune system. It's a challenge to the immune system. When you stop smoking, your immune system is likely to boost. If you have to drink alcohol, drink minimally. Medically, your drinking should not be heavy. And I like to tell you that when you eat, eat healthy. Eat healthy meals. Don't eat because you see the meal. Okay? Eat what your body needs. Now, I believe that you have learned one of the things. If you find this video good, please do me good by subscribing, like, share, and if you have any question, be free to comment. I will respond. Don't forget to click on the notification bell so that you can have access to more of medical tips like this. They are useful for you. I'd like you to stay safe. I'd like you to stay healthy. Till next time we see again on this channel, my name is Dr. Omoniyi Adeyeye. I love you.